How to draw graffiti letters for beginners. A graffitiknowhow.com web article posted on June 1st, 2014 and revised July 3rd, 2015 by Graffiti Know How. In this article, you will learn how to graft graffiti letters for beginners step by step. Graffiti can take a lot of perseverance, but it's well worth it. I've traveled all over the world, met some really good friends with many different countries, had lots of adventures, and paid a lot of money by big businesses who want the urban look. Luckily for you, I'll help you skip the hard learning curve and avoid mistakes most people make when they start out. By the time you'll finish reading this graffiti tutorial, we'll have recovered all the basic steps you need. Then, with practice, you can go on to develop your own style. Below are some examples of different artist styles from all over the world. For the world's top 20 most famous graffiti artists, click here. Putting pencil to paper is the best way to gain a good understanding of how to draw graffiti. And it's good to know as well about a little bit of its history. The more you know about the early days of graffiti and its origins, the bigger advantage you have when it comes to style and skill. To check out our graffiti timeline infographic, click here. Subway Art is the book about the beginning of graffiti and has paved the way for different artists' styles all over the world. Graffiti artists praise the book and refer to it as their Bible. I don't know a graffiti artist who hasn't read it, and most will have a copy buried somewhere in their home. Another great resource is the documentary Style Wars, made by Henry Chaffon, one of the authors of Subway Art, that covers the lives of some of the artists in the book. It's a really vibrant account of a time when New York subcars resembled a public art gallery. Here is the trailer YouTube recording of Style Wars trailer. We will be playing it at the end of the video, given that there is time and processing power. The most credible writers today all have elements of early style in their work, so know your history. For further inspiration, it's really good to seek out art on the walls of your local area and take some photos. In most large cities, there are legal walls where artists can paint with permission. Usually you'll find a high standard of graffiti here because artists can spend many hours there without fear of being arrested. This is normally a pretty high turnover painting area as people paint on top of previous work. Legal Walls is a great website that allows you to locate these walls in your local area. In the age of internet, it is easy to search online for photos of graffiti from all over the world. But if you look around your own city, you'll see recurring themes in different artist styles. I personally think it's good for writers to maintain these trends as it gives each city its own unique contribution to the movement. If you do graffiti with a group of friends, aka a crew, you might find that you'll all develop similar styles. Don't copy another artist's style directly. This is known as biting and makes you look uncreative and bit of a fraud. Most people do this to some degree when they're starting, maybe even unintentionally, whether admitted or not, but don't claim someone else's style as your own. What separates a real innovative artist from a mediocre one is their ability to develop ideas from their letters outside graffiti, from illustration, comics, art, and the world around them. You can get inspiration from anywhere. And so now it's time for the action. The lesson will cover how to develop letter form and draw the outlines of your letters, so you will need some tools. The foundation of graffiti is typography. Typography is the basic art of letters. Even the font you're reading now was originally drawn or designed by someone. Graffiti writers have a good understanding of typography and often go on into successful careers in graphic design and creative fields. In graffiti, we primarily use the sans-serif letters, which don't have any serifs. Sans is French for without. And serifs are extended strokes on the ends of letters. Let's look at the alphabet made up of capitals, as the majority of graffiti pieces use capital letters because they are normally more interesting to work with and look stronger. Here is a sans-serif alphabet. Sure, you've seen one before. The letters are made up of bars, some straight and curved, all the thickness and even gaps between them. Have a look at a bar structure of the letters. Practice drawing some of the letters from the sans-serif alphabet. Concentrate on the equal thickness of the bars, the angle, symmetry, and the spaces of the gaps in the letters. When you start drawing graffiti, use bars to build your letters. After time, you'll have a good idea of how style and letter structure and of your own style and letter structure, and won't need to keep this up, which means being able to paint much quicker. So now you know the basic understanding of letter structure, I'm going to share with you the most important secret to style. A friend of mine once described this perfectly by saying how writing a tag, the simplest form of graffiti, is like doing a dance. Often when people start, theirs look really deliberate and forced. The reason graffiti appeals to the human eye is because the letters have energy and movement that resemble life and that evokes emotion in the viewer. This is why the use of arrows is common in graffiti. They are a symbol of direction. So it figures that if symbols we call letters could really move, they would have arrows to indicate their direction. The moment in your letters also comes from the way they're painted. Unlike many other methods of drawing or painting, when you do graffiti, you use the whole body. When you sketch your outline on the wall, you spray paint, you stretch and sweep your arms, you lean, you bend your knees. Also, due to inherently illegal nature, graffiti has traditionally been painted at speed, and this is why the lines and strokes in graffiti look so dynamic and fluid. Remember, when drawing, your letters have to give the impression of movement and life. Here's an example of how a simple letter can evolve to have more character. If you look at the second image in the left, from the left, you can see just how giving the vertical bars of the letter a natural looking curve instantly gives it a bit more energy and personality. Often writers' own personality is seen in their pieces. A guy with the constant new wardrobe who wants to fit in will always have the latest trends of graffiti, while the quiet guy with eyes like daggers will have letters who look like they could eat you alive. Try and put some of your own work into your work. Hello, my name is a sticker to pick your own graffiti name or tag. Some writers change their names over time as they get better or bored for the letters. Others stick with the same throughout their graffiti career. A tag is the simplest form of graffiti and does not include three-dimensionality or block lettering. Instead, it is a pen stroke with movement. Once you've picked your name, do some research to make sure no one famous or prolific is writing the same thing. This will save you embarrassment. Write your chosen name in capitals on a bit of paper and see how it looks. Follow this step-by-step example as you draw your own word. The author here started with the word learn, writing in block letters, evenly spaced, with each letter at an opposite skew. As we go through these steps, try out different techniques with your letters. See which ones work and which don't. Drawing letters is all about experimenting, so sketch lightly and make sure you have an eraser ready to make out the basic bits you don't need and to take out the basic bits you don't need and need to replace. Here's a second draft of Learn with the letters curved naturally and some serifs added, however, very subtly. In the third version of the drawing or the writing, the L and the E have been transformed into a more dynamic combination of letters. A serif has been added to the top of the A as well as the bottom of the A, connecting to the R with the top serif, and a lower serif on the right connecting to the N, which also has an upper serif on the right, continuing to maintain the curve. In the fourth painting, or fifth, the final version, or close to final version, we see arrows added to impress upon the viewer directionality. A star, which is evocative of the culture of urban graffiti, and a spade, which as well is part of the wild style. Eventually, when your graffiti is close to completion, take an eraser, take a pen, and ink over the permanent lines, and take an eraser to erase the light-colored sketching, and you'll have a final version that can be manipulated further with line weight, illustration, etc. Here we have the final version of Learn with the arrows, the spades, the serifs, and the general connection of the letters with separation as well. Finally, go over your final outline with a pen and eraser, and erase all the guidelines you've used to make your bars. You can work on different areas of drawing graffiti, like adding shadow or 3Ds or highlights or color. Now you know how to draw graffiti letters. Practice makes perfect. Once you've gotten good at the basics, move on. Break the rules you've learned. Start trying different things and develop your own style. If you've got any questions and you'd like to know something that I didn't cover, leave a comment below. Painting on property that does not belong to you without permission is illegal. Need some reason why you shouldn't do graffiti? Click here. You'll find the guide useful, and if you please, have it shared. I really enjoyed this article because it was cogent, it was insightful, and it provided a great deal of information that was valuable, essentially valuable to the beginning graffiti artist. So I wrote a pleasant and commendable or commending comment for posting both on Facebook and in this blog, and I'll read it. Righteously Stellar Tutorial, GKH.com. You bring a knowledgeable expertise and currently cutting-edge freshness to your taste for creativity, graffiti training, education, in a way that substantially well informs beginning level graffiti artists with extremely valuable, generally essential fundamentals that are communicated and illustrated in ways that are very easy to grasp and put into practice. Thanks, yo. I learned a great deal from this article and your effort remains committed to elevating the urban arts to a higher respect and culture. Matthew Blanchard. About.me/Matthew Blanchard. bit.ly/Matthew Blanchard. behance.net/QuasiMatto. scribe.com/QuasiMatto. vimeo.com/QuasiMatto. San Francisco, California, USA. Commenting. A wonderful article about how to draw graffiti for beginners by graffitiknowhow.com. Let's take a last review of the pictures in reverse order. Wild style with arrows, stars, spades, curvatures, and line connections, and a high level of curvature and angularity. The basics of curvature and serif manipulation. The basics of curvature to add movement and dynamism to an otherwise block lettering, as seen here. And here is the tag name. The demonstration of the A and its evolution into a more dynamic, movemented character. Sans serif bar structures for letters. The sans serif alphabet. A serif letter with purple serifs. Sans serif means without serif in French. Here is the trailer for Style Wars posted on YouTube that will play and video record with MobiZen as we speak.
going on right in your dick, you're on.
Somebody let me know.
Well, everybody in the place, put a whistle in your face, scream it out, say yo. Hey,
you don't stop. I write the rhythm that makes your finger pop. I said, hip hop, thanks a lot. Come on, everybody, give me what you got. I'm gonna tell you a little story about the Sugar Hill Gang with the pow pow boogie and a big bang bang.
Concourse 149th Street Station in the Bronx, graffiti writers gather at what they call the writer's bench.
They're saying that the kids run the subways, that the system is out of control, that 15 and 16 year old kids are running the system, and that graffiti is a symbol of that.
Nah, I ain't running the system.
Hell yeah.
I'm bombing the system. They're trying to make it look like graffiti riders break windows and everything. It ain't even like that.
You know who be doing that, man? Niggas who be high when they come from school,
right,
are the ones who break the windows.
And it's in the graffiti artist's favor to be as cool, calm, and collected about putting his art on the train as he can. You know, he wants to get in and get out without even being noticed, except for the work that's going to come out to the public, that, you know, that Monday.
Thank you for watching. And I hope that this recording is helpful in documenting the great amount of resources available as information and instruction with how to graffiti writing for beginners.